Welcome everybody once again. So we are in our third class for module 3 and we have studied what is Bernoulli's equation. So we saw how to derive the Bernoulli's equation from Euler's equation, and we saw what is Bernoulli's equation for ideal fluid and real fluid. We know if the fluid is said to be ideal if the viscosity is equal to zero. That means it is non-viscous. But in reality, all the fluids have some viscous property. So if a fluid is ideal fluid, our Bernoulli's equation is P by rho g plus V square by 2g plus z is equal to constant. That means P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. That is the meaning of this. If you take any sections, see, when you are considering a pipe, if the fluid is ideal, you take any section, this total energy, this is called a total energy. So this total energy will be equal. So pressure head, velocity head and datum head. So this total energy will be same at all the sections. That is the meaning of that. But if the fluid is, so this is for ideal, right? If the fluid is real, so for real fluids, our Bernoulli's equation is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus losses, that we will write it as HL, losses. So this is the condition for real fluids. Real fluids. See, that means this is your total energy at section 1. This is your total energy at section 2. So your total energy at section, sorry. This is your total energy at section 2. So that means when you are considering a pipe, when you are considering a pipe for a real fluids, if this is your section 1 and this is your section 2, the total energy at section 1, total energy at section 1 minus total energy at section 2 will be equal to the losses. That means your energy at the section 2, because the water is flowing in this direction. So the energy at the section 2 will always be less than the total energy at section 1. If the water is flowing in this direction, the total energy in section 1 will be less than the total energy in section 2. Because when the water is flowing from this to this, there will be some losses in between. Now, if the water is flowing in this direction, there will be some losses when the water is flowing from 1 to 2. So, total energy at section 1 minus total energy at section 2 will be losses, or total energy at section 1 will be equal to total energy at section 2 plus losses. Okay, see, so we have studied all these concepts. We have seen it clearly in the previous classes. Then we saw some five examples using this Bernoulli's equations. Now we will move on to our sixth example. So our problem is, okay, so our problem is a pipe of diameter 40 cm carries water at a velocity of 25 meter per second. So we have only one diameter, that is 40 cm. And the velocity is 25 meter per second. The pressures at the points A and B are given as 3 kilogram force per centimeter square and 2.3 kilogram force per centimeter square. See, pressure head is given in terms of centimeter or meters. Pressure intensity is given in terms of Newton per centimeter square. So what we get is, see, we have two sections A and B. So the pressure intensity at two sections, that is P1 and P2, is given. The velocity is given as 25 meter per second. Now, the datum head at A and B are 28 meter and 30 meter. So Z1 is 28 meter and Z2 is 30 meter. Find the loss of head between A and B. So how will we determine this? See, only one velocity is given. That means VA is equal to VB. Velocity is the same at section A and section B. Now, with the help of this datum head, we will draw the diagram first. So the pipe is 40 centimeter. And at A, the datum head at A is 28 meters. So suppose we will consider this as our datum head. Okay. This is our datum. So this point is datum line. This is taken as our reference datum. So from this, the datum head at A is 28 meter and the datum head at B is 30 meter. So this will be our center line of the pipe. So our pipe is 40 centimeter diameter. So from this we will take 20 centimeter this side and 20 centimeter this side. So we will draw a pipe . So this pipe is of diameter 40 centimeter. So this is our section at A. So this will be section at A and this will be section at B. So now it is given this distance, that is at A, Z1 is equal to 28 centimeter. That means this distance is 28 centimeter. That is equal to 0.28 meter. And this distance is from this to this. The distance is 30 centimeter. That is equal to 0.3 meter. So this is Z1 and Z2. Now, the diameter is 40 centimeter. So everywhere the diameter D1 is equal to 40 centimeter, that is equal to 0.4 meter. Similarly, D2 is also 40 centimeter, so that is equal to 0.4 meter. The velocity is 25 meter per second. So only one velocity is given. That is not given at section A or B, it is given as velocity. So V1 is equal to 25 meter per second. V2 is also equal to 25 meter per second. Now, the pressures at point A and B are given as 3 kilogram force per centimeter square. That means our pressure intensity P1. So P1 is equal to 3 kilogram force per centimeter square. So converting it into Newton per meter square, we get 3 into 9.81 in order to convert kilogram force to Newton. In order to convert centimeter square to meter square, we have to divide it by 100 square. So it is 10 raised to 4. Right? So multiply by 10 raised to 4 because it is 1 by centimeter square is equal to, when you are dividing, it is 1 by 1/100 × 100. Okay, so we are multiplying it by 10^4. In other words, 1 cm² is equal to 10^4 meter square. Is equal to 1/10^4 meter square. So 1/1 cm² is equal to 10^4 meter square. That is why it is we are multiplying it by 10^4. Now, Z1 and Z2 are given as, this is Newton per meter square. Similarly, our P2 will be equal to, it is given as 2.3 kilogram force per centimeter square. So 2.3 kilogram force per centimeter square, that is equal to 2.3 into 9.81 into 10^4 Newton per meter square. Okay. Now, find the loss of head between A and B. We are asked to find the loss of head. That means we have to apply the Bernoulli's equation for real fluids. So we know Bernoulli's equation for a real fluid is P1/ρg plus V1² / 2g plus Z1. So here it is, the section is taken as A and B. We will replace 1/A is equal to PB/ρg plus VB² / 2g plus ZB plus the losses, that is HL. So we are asked to find the loss of head, HL. So what is HL now? HL is equal to PA minus PB by rho g plus VA² - VB² / 2g plus ZA - ZB. Right? So we get HL is equal to, what is PA? 3 × 9.81 × 10^4 - 2.3 × 9.81 × 10^4 divided by rho, as rho for water is 1000 into g is 9.81 plus VA square. Velocity VA is given as 25. So 25² - 25². So this term becomes 0. 2 × 9.81 plus 0. ZA - ZB. ZA - ZB is 28 - 30. So what we get is, see, this is called the pressure head. So this PA is called the pressure, PA by rho g is called pressure head at A, PB by rho g is called pressure head at B. So finally, we get the loss of energy as 5 m. Now, see, for your exam point of view, you will be, see, this is our concept, this is our answer. For our exam point of view, you will be expected to find the total energy at A, total energy at B, and losses is equal to total energy at A minus total energy at B. So for your exam point of view, how will you solve this? First of all, find the total energy at A. So what is your total energy at A? So total energy at A is equal to PA by rho g plus VA square by 2g plus Z1. You will get the value as total energy at A as 89.85 meter. Similarly, total energy at B will be equal to PB by rho g plus VB square by 2g plus Z1. So you get total energy at B will be equal to 84.85 meter. So loss of energy will be equal to total energy at A minus total energy at B. So that is 5 meter. See, for exam point of view, you will be expected to find the total energy at A and total energy at B. Because you will have marks, your mark distribution will be like this. So it is better to find total energy at A, total energy at B, and then find the losses. So this I explained you in a simple manner from the formula. So directly you can get the answer like this. Now we will move on to the next problem. Our next problem is a conical tube of length 2 meter is fixed vertically with its smaller end upwards. So you have a conical tube. It has two ends, one smaller end and upper end. So you have a tapering cross section. So smaller end is upwards and the length is 2 meters. So we will draw it. See, the smaller end is upwards. So the larger end is downwards and the length. Total length is given as 2 meters. Now, it is fixed vertically. That is why we have drawn a vertical cone. Okay, vertical cone. The velocity of flow at the smaller end is 5 meter per second. So here the velocity is 5 meter per second. While the lower end is 2 meter per second. So at the lower end, our velocity is equal to 2 meter per second. Now, the pressure head at the smaller end is 2.5 meter of liquids. So that means P's pressure head means P by rho g. So we will take this as our section 1, smaller end as section 1 and the larger end as section 2. So this we will take it as a section 2. So that means, see, it is given the loss, the pressure head at the smaller end is 2.5 meter of liquid. That means P1 by rho g is equal to 2.5 meter of liquid. Now, the loss of head in the tube is 0.35 into V1 minus V2 the whole square by 2g. That means our loss of head HL is equal to 0.35 into V1 minus V2 the whole square by 2g. That is equal to 0.35 into 5 minus V1 is 5 and V2 is 2. 5 minus 2 the whole square by 2 into 9.81, we get it as 0.16 meter. Okay, where V1 and V2 are the velocities and smaller and lower ends respectively. Determine the pressure head at the lower end. You are asked to find what is the pressure head at the lower end. Pressure head at the lower end means you are asked to find what is P2 by rho g. Flow takes place in the downward direction. Your flow is taking place in the downward direction. So, when it reaches 2, you will have losses. You are asked to find what is P2 by rho g. So, see, we will consider this as our datum head. So, this level is 0. This level is 2 meter. Okay. So, now we will apply the Bernoulli's equation. That is P1 by rho g plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 is equal to p2 by rho g plus v2 square by 2g plus z2 plus losses. Now, p1 by rho g is given as 2.5 meter of liquid. That means it is 2.5. So, this is 2.5 plus b1 square by 2g. V1 is given as 5 meter per second, right? So, 5 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus z1. So, the section 1 is 2 meter from the datum. So, it is 2 meter is equal to p2 by rho g. That is what we need to find, okay? P2 by rho g plus v2 square is 2. 2 square by 2 into 9.81. Plus z2 lies at the datum head, so it is 0 plus losses. Losses is 0.16. So, substituting all the values, you get the only unknown is p2 by rho g. This is what we need to find. We get p2 by rho g will be equal to 5.407 meter of fluid or liquid. So, this is our answer. So, last problem of today, one more problem, that is a pipeline carrying oil of specific gravity 0.87 changes in diameter from 200 mm diameter at a position A to 500 mm diameter at a position B, which is 4 meter at a higher level. So, position B is 4 meter higher than position A. So, how can we draw that? So, A and B, right? So, we will consider this as our center line. So, this is our section A and this our section B. Now, so it consists of an oil. It is carrying an oil of specific gravity 0.87. It changes, sorry, the diagram is wrong, because it changes its diameter from 200 mm to 500 mm. So it cannot be drawn like this, right? So, the center line will be like this. Okay. So, now section A and section B. So, diameter at A is 200 mm. So, here our D1 is equal to 200 mm. That is equal to 0.2 meter. And diameter D2 is equal to 500 mm. That is equal to 0.5 meter. Right? Now, at a position B, which is 4 meters at a higher level. So, from this to this, the difference between the center lines of A and B is 4 meter. That means ZB minus ZA is equal to 4 meter. Okay. That is the meaning of that. At a position B, which is 4 meter at a higher level, you take the difference between the center line. So, this difference is 4 meter. So, if you consider this as the datum line, this is your zero level and this is 4 meter above A. So, ZB minus ZA is 4 meter. If the pressures at A and B are 1 kilogram force per centimeter square, So PA is given as 1 kilogram force per centimeter square, that is equal to 1 into 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 newton per meter square. In order to convert kilogram force to newton, you multiply it by 9.81 centimeter square to meter square divided by 10 raised to 4. So centimeter square is in the denominator, so we multiply it by 10 raised to 4. And 0.6. So PB is equal to pressure intensity at B is 0.6 kilogram force per centimeter square. That is equal to 0.6 into 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 newton per meter square. And the discharge is 200 liters per second. So discharge means your Q is given as 200 liters per second. We know 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters. So in order to convert liters to meter cube, we have to divide it by 1000. So it is 0.2 meter cube per second. Determine the loss of head and direction of flow. You need to find what is HL and the direction of flow. Okay, so first of all, we will find HL. For in order to find the losses, our formula is, we will apply the Bernoulli's equation, that is PA square by rho g plus VA square by 2g plus ZA is equal to PB square by rho g plus VB square by 2g plus ZB. So we need to find what is the velocity at A and B, right? So we know Q is equal to A1, B1 is equal to A2, B2. So relating these both first, Q is 0.2 meter cube per second. So 0.2 is equal to area, that is pi d square by 4, d is 0.2. So 0.2 square divided by 4 into velocity is V1, from which we get V1 is equal to VA, right? V1 means VA. It is area at A and velocity at A. Area at B, velocity at B. So we get VA equal to 6.369 meter per second. Similarly, equating these both, we get 0.2 is equal to pi into diameter at B. That is 0.5 square, d square by 4 into VB, from which we get velocity at B will be equal to 1.018 meter per second. Now we can substitute PA square, that is, see, we will take it together, sorry, this plus HL, losses. So, HL will be equal to 1 by rho g of PA minus PB. There is no square here. Sorry. Plus 1 by 2g into VA square minus VB square plus ZA minus ZB. See, if ZB minus ZA is 4 meter, ZA minus ZB will be equal to minus 4 meter. So now substituting the values, we get 1 by rho is 1000, g is 9.81 into PA. See, everywhere PA and PB, it is 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 is common. So we will take it out, 9.81 into 10 raised to 4, just 1 minus at PB 0.6. We have taken 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 outside, plus 1 by 2 into 9.81 into VA square minus VB square. VA is 6.369 minus VB is 1.018. plus ZA minus ZB. ZA minus ZB is minus 4. So what we get is HL is equal to meter. Now, in order to find the direction of a flow, we need to find what is EA and EB, right? See, we will be able to find the direction of a flow after finding EA, that is total energy at A. So, EA means total energy at A, that is PA by rho G plus V1 square by 2G plus Z A. ZA is 0. This is taken as the datum line. So, ZA is taken as 0. What we get is, you substitute the values. PA is 1 into 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 divided by 1000 into 9. So that is equal to 1 into 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus VA is 6.369 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus 0, because this is taken as the datum line. So what we get is energy at A, EA will be equal to 13.557 meter. Similarly, our EB, that is total energy at B, is equal to PB by rho G plus VB square by 2G plus ZB. So PB is 0.6 into 9.81 into 10 raised to 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus VB square. VB is 1.018 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus ZB is 4 meter above the data. So it is 4. So what we get is energy at B will be equal to 10.948 meter. So you see, you compare both energy at A and energy at B. Energy at A is higher energy. That means when the water is flowing from A to B, there is some losses. That means your direction of flow is from A to B. How will you conclude it? See, we will conclude by saying EA is greater than EB. Total energy at A is greater than total energy at B, which means the direction of a flow, so don't have space, direction of, I will write it at the top, okay? So EA, energy at A is greater than energy at B, which means the direction of a flow is from A to B. Okay, so the direction of flow is from A to B. In this way, the water is, the oil is flowing in this direction. Okay, I forgot to tell you something. There is a mistake somewhere. That is, specific gravity is given as 0.87. That means your density, when you are considering the density, rho, density for oil is 0.87. Density is equal to 0.87 into 1000. We get 870 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, so density is equal to 1000 into 0.87 into 1000. Okay. Here also it is 0.87 into 1000. 0.87 into 1000. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. We will see the remaining problems in the next class. Thank you.